Hill Studio. This is Leanne Jago again. I'm just here today with a blog post, and it's called Ivy. So it's goodies that I got from Art and Soul Studio. So we're going to go through the whole process. So from when I opened the box to the end product. Now I'm not sure what happened in the filming of this, but it went blurry at the end. So you can still see what I'm doing, but you're just going to have to put up with it, I guess. So I decided to use this stamp here. It was the Finnebar Now is the Right Time, and then some papers from Dreamscapes. I can't remember who it was, but someone put up a post in the Art and Soul Studio Soul Sisters group where I asked about what you wanted or something that inspires you, and something someone came up with the Dream Big theme. So this is sort of where it sort of started with that one. So it was about dreams. So I'm just going through the papers. This is the 7 Dot Studios Dreamscapes collection. Flicking through, there's a couple of good ones in there that I've got some really good ideas with, but I went with this one, which is Narwhal. Okay, so first up, just getting the Matisse transparent gesso out and just covering the paper. I know it's going to be a mixed media item, so just sealing the paper just to help it. The paint and the ink and everything else that I put on there, and protect the paper a little bit as well. Okay, so what I wanted to do was to stamp this stamp onto a piece of tissue paper and then apply it to the background, because I didn't want it, again, because I know I'm using mixed media, I didn't want to have to stamp onto a mixed media background because the stamps don't come out nice. I mean, it's all lumpy and bumpy, so yeah. So just using some stays-on black ink, just stamp the stamp. This. It's just a piece of greaseproof kitchen paper. I find it works really well, so works for me, so I'm going with it. It might not technically be right for scrapbooking, but hey. Just wasn't quite dry in the background. All the products that I've used will be in the description box below. Over to the Art and Soul Studio, 15% off store wide all the time, so you know, pretty good prices and great range. So, right, so I was thinking about the background. I'm like, okay, I know I wanted to put some texture somewhere. I got my stencils out. No, none of them were working for me. So then I just applied some Liquitex light modeling paste to the background, and then I got this really cool embossing folder from Caravelle Studios. It's the Text Grunge one, so I just pressed that into the texture paste. You can't really see, obviously, on this video right now. Then I got some of the Silks acrylic glaze in the Nutmeg. It looks kind of like, I'm going to say it, baby poo, but it actually comes up really nice. Just using a Tim Holtz stencil, just applying it randomly through that. Again, this is just all background, so we're just playing. So this is the way that I had designed the page when I looked at it. This is the way it was going to set up, but then yeah, just wait and see. Oh, my water bottle broke, so I had to wash out an old glimmer mist bottle and use it, so it kind of didn't work very well. But anyway, there's some orange coming through. So what I'm using there is just the Lindy Stamp Gang Magical Shakers in the Cuckoo Clock Cardinal, Oompa-pa Pink, Yodeling Yellow, and Oktoberfest Orange, just with a little bit of water. And then it came up too bright, so I just wiped it off with some paper towel. Just using some white gesso around the outside just and through the middle there, just to give it a bit of a grunge up look. Again, with the Stabilo pencil, I added it early, so I'll have to go back over that later on, but you know, it's the way thing goes. Comes out, works all right in the end, so. I love the Stabilo pencil. I think I mentioned that before, so. And I think it just finishes the page. It just makes a nice border on it. So here we go with the stamp. So I'm deciding which way it goes. I had this photo of Ivy because it was near Dream Big. I was going to use that. Actually ended up deciding to use the change the orientation of the layout. So you see that. So I've just ripped that the stamp off of the bit of tissue. Just with some Art Deco some texture paste just around the outside, just so that, for me, like, even though when it dries you can't see the edging, it just sort of makes me feel a little bit better. Again, with the Magicals, just in again, just wanted a little bit more colour. Again, deciding it's too much, so take some away. That's what I love about these things. It's just all trial and error. You'll see later on that I add something to the page, and it just didn't feel right, so I end up picking it off a little bit later on. So now I'm just going through where the heart was on the stamp. It actually had art written in there, so I cut that out because I didn't want art on there. So just applying that stamped heart over the top again. Knowing where I'm going to put the photo of Ivy, so I map the photo, thinking, yep, I'm ready to add it in, I'll just stick things in and then I'll change the color. Used one of the Viva Las Vegas stamps just to do the background. Added Ivy. I knew I wanted to use these tags somehow. I didn't like the circle punch part of the tag, so I actually used a Martha Stewart butterfly punch there, and on one of them I punched a bit out. Now, because I'm not one that layers things around and then sticks later on, I just stick a photo down and then add bits around it. So I have to cut the tags to fit, which is fine. I mean, it still works well. Works out in the end, so fine if I sit there and shuffle. I'm not a paper shuffle, I just stick things down, and if it doesn't work, I pull it back up, I put something else down. So that's basically what I'm doing. I did do a little bit down the bottom there as well. Just using some of the chipboard from the Dreamscapes range as well. So I added that little bit at the side, and then I added that one underneath the photo, so that will disappear eventually. Going around things with the Stabilo just to give a bit extra definition. Because I added that tag and that down the bottom there, so I wanted the border to come back around. And then just highlighting those tags that I've added underneath the photo as well. So I'm just colouring in that chipboard just with some of the Silks Glaze in the Nutmeg and the Silver Bells. Using the paper towel that I had before, I actually just dabbled it onto those pieces of chipboard, and that actually worked really, really well. I was really happy with the way that worked, because I had been using leftover ink, I suppose, that I'd used before. So now I'm thinking it just needed a bit of something, so I just got out some thread. I knew I wanted to shove it up there, so I was just playing with it, seeing how it went, and trying to glue it down, and it just sort of gets stuck to your fingers. It ends up working. Again, just testing things, seeing what I wanted. So these are the Tim Holtz transparent ideology tiles that were in my little kit at the start. So I just used Ivy, playing around where I wanted to position them. See how I ripple that? There goes that piece of thing that I said I just didn't. Just wasn't working for me. So then fixing it. So I end up having to add another tag over top just to get rid of that. But then in the end, you can't see it, so I don't know why I bothered. But anyway, it's the way it goes. So I thought I can't have this, so I'll just staple down the bottom for all of the products that I've used at the studio. Here you go, lots of like yummy textures. I really, really liked how this turned out. It was one of my favorites, so. Thank you very much for watching. So that's it for me today. Please leave comments down the bottom. Sorry again about the blurriness. Have a good day.